I'd like to show you how to minimize a deterministic finite state automaton. And minimizing means if we have several states that have the same function, that means if we are in those states, we can read the same set of words so that they will be accepted. So if those states have the same function, we don't need both, so we can merge them into one. And I show you how that works. But one important thing first, we can't actually say if two states are equal or equivalent. We can only prove if two states are not equivalent. Let me give you an example. Let's say in an automaton you have one final state and you have another final state. And you say, okay, those are final states. I think they are equivalent. But no, they are not. Because maybe if you are in this state, let me make you clear, those final states belong to the same automaton. Maybe if you are in this state, you can read an A, so that those A will be, then the word will still be accepted. And if you are in this state, you may can read an A, and then it will not be accepted, and then those states will not be equivalent. But I show you how to say which states are equivalent. So first I have to draw a matrix where I can compare each of the states, and I draw the matrix so that I don't need the full rectangle or the full table. So O1, Q2, 3, I need to draw one column and row for each state, or so that I can compare each pairs with each other. And those task tells us to add a trap state first. That's because in our area we are allowed to leave trap states away, because we say if we have an arc that goes into this trap state, then you can leave it away, and if an arc isn't drawn in an automaton, then it leaves into a trap state. So for minimizing, we have to add them first. And as you can see, we have arcs with A or with B. And state 1 doesn't have an arc with an A. So that means that those arc goes into the trap state. I name it QF for false or something like that. It doesn't matter how it's named. And with A and B, because from this state there are no arcs defined with A and B, so I know they go into the trap state. And the trap state of course has loop to itself with any symbols that are possible in the automaton. So, and if you look at all the other states, then all of them have arcs, leaving arcs with A and B defined. So this is the only place where we can go into the trap state. So, but we need them for minimization. Q4, 3, 2, Q1. I didn't write down all the states in rows and columns, because if I add Q0, I don't really need it, because I can compare Q0 with every one of the others in this column, so I don't need a Q0 here. So it's just one. You can draw the whole table if you want to, but it's not needed. It's not necessary. So now we have the table. And now we go through each of those pairs and see if we can find a proof that those both states are not equivalent. I'll give you an exam. First we start with comparing final states with the others. Because if we are in a final state, then we don't need to read any other symbols so that they will be accepted. That means in those states we can read an epsilon and it will be accepted. But if we are in another state, for example in Q0, and we read an epsilon, and then it will not be accepted because we are in a state that is not a final state, and we just stay here when reading epsilon. So we can say that Q1 is not equivalent to any one of those other states, and we can just make Marx's cell with a cross to say it, or we can write down what proof we have that they are not equivalent. So I can write down epsilon, and that means epsilon is a proof that Q1 and the trap state are not equivalent. So, and so the same with all the others. So if you have a trap state, if you compare two states and one is a trap state and the other one is not, then you can tell with epsilon that those both are not equivalent. So here's another Q1 with Q0, and so now we have compared all states with Q1. So in the next step we have to go through all the states and try to find a proof that those states are not equivalent. So, for example, if we have QF on Q0, let me draw this for you. Let me assume that we are in Q0, and if we are in Q0 and we take those B arc, then we go into Q1 and we are in the final state. And if we are in the trap state, and we take those B arcs, then we go into a state that is not a final state. So if you have a look at this cell, when we go from from Q0 with a B in Q1 and the Q from QF with a B into QF, then we already have compared those both, and that is this cell. So when we do those B transition from those both states, we go actually into this cell, and we already are in those both states, and from those both states we know that they are not equivalent because we wrote down a proof here. So I can write down a B because those B proves that Q1 and Q0 and QF are not equivalent, because from Q0 with a B I go to Q1, and from QF with a B I go to QF. And we already know that those both are not equivalent. So we could also find another proof when we go from Q0 with an A arc. If we go from QA with an if we go from Q0 with an A arc to Q2, or we go from QF with an A arc, then we go to QF, and then with an A, I mark it with a color, we would go into Q and F, and that would be this cell, and we don't know from this cell yet if those both are equivalent or not. So with an A we couldn't say anything about this those two states, but with a B we can. Now we go on with our comparison. From QF and Q2, From Q2, we have arcs with A and B to Q3, and we didn't compare Q3 with anything, so we don't know yet. Or let me make this clear for you. From QF, we already know that we do an arc with from QF, we land in QF, and from Q2, we can only go to Q3. And Q3 and QF, we don't know if they're equivalent yet. I have to go through all the cells of the table, and if anything changes, like it did for this cell, then I have to go through the whole table again. And if nothing changes anymore in the table, then I'm done. So, next I have to compare QF with Q3. With Q3, we have an arc with B to Q1, and QF we also know is QF. And Q1, QF we already compared, so we know that Q3 and QF are not equivalent, and those B gives us the proof. So, QF and Q4. Q4 has a transition with B to Q0, and QF, of course, has a transition to QF. And from QF and Q0, we already know that they are not equivalent. So I can add those be here that gives me the proof. But I also could use those A arc and go from Q4 to Q3. And of course I have to take those A arc at the same time. And from Q3 and QF all in those cell I already wrote those B. So A would be another proof that those that Q4 and QF are not equivalent. So Q4 and Q0. From Q0, if we take an arc, we go to Q2. Well, I guess I don't. Maybe I don't really need to look at it. But anyway, so Q0 with an A arc, I go to Q2. And Q4, I go with an A arc to Q3. And I didn't compare Q2 and 3 yet, so I don't know yet. But if I take an A arc from Q4, I go to Q3. And from Q0 with an B, I go to Q1, so I have to look in the cell of Q1 and Q3. And I already wrote an epsilon, so those cell. I know that Q0 and Q4 are not equivalent because when I take an A, I go from Q4 to Q3 and from Q0 to Q1, and I already know that Q3 and 1 are not equivalent because I wrote those epsilon down in it. So the next is Q4 and Q2 have to be compared. When I take any arc from Q2, I go to Q3. And from Q4, with an A, I go to Q3 as well. That, it's the same. It brings me nothing at the moment. But when I go from Q4 to Q0, let's see, Q0 and Q3. Well, I didn't write down anything in it, so I can't say anything for those cell yet. And I have to go to the next. So Q3 and Q4. With an A, they only switch places, as you see. With Q3, I go to Q1 with a B. And from Q4 with a B, I go to Q0. And 1 and 0. Where is it? Oh, I wrote down an epsilon. So those, what did I say? With a B transition, you have the proof and that Q3 and Q4 are not equivalent. So Q3 and 0. With a B, both to go to Q1, that doesn't tell me anything. And from Q0, with an A, I go to Q2. And from Q3, with a 0, I go to QA. So 4 and 2, I can't tell anything about the cell yet. Q3 and Q2, I wanted to say. With Q2, I go into Q3, no matter which arc I take. And with Q3, I go into, with an A, I go into 4, so 2 and 4, 3 and 4, sorry. 3 and 4, oh, I have a B in it. Oh, I guess maybe it wasn't clear. So, when I take an arc from Q2 with a B to Q3, and from Q3 with a B to Q1, I have to compare Q1 and Q3. Then I have already wrote down something into this cell. So a B gives me a proof that 2 and 3 are not equivalent. So 2 and 0. With an A, I go from 0 to 2, or I go from 2 to 3, so I have to compare 2 and 3 for the cell. And I already wrote this B into it, so an A gives me a proof. So it was the first time I looked through all the cells. Now because I changed something in any cell, I have to go through the whole matrix again and see if something else changes. I have only to compare for those cells. I didn't wrote anything into it yet. So QF and Q2. With Q2 with an A or B, I go into Q3. And from QF, of course, I will always land in QF. So I have it look into the cell Q3 and QF, and I already wrote something in. So I know, well, doesn't matter if I take an A or a B, because from Q2 that is the same arc, or the maybe two arcs that leave into the same state with A or with B, and QF also with A and with B, I go into QF. So, and those both cells, I have to look at them again. Q2 and Q4. From Q2, I land in Q3. And from Q4, I land always again in Q3 when I take an A arc. Or when I take a B arc, I have to compare 3 and 0. I didn't write down into it something yet. And Q0 and 3. From Q0 with a B or from Q3 with a B, I go into Q1. That doesn't tell me anything. And from Q0 with an A, I go into Q2. And from Q3 into Q4. And 2 and 4, well, I didn't say, I can't tell about something about that, because there's nothing in that cell. So, exactly, I changed something in the last looking through the table, but, I did it enough times to see that when I look into those cell, I have to look into those cell, and if I want to compare for those cell, then I have to look into those cell. So I will not find any proof that those are not equivalent when I would go into the whole table again. So I know they are equivalent. That means Q2 is equivalent to Q4 and Q3 is equivalent to Q0. So the task now tells me that I have to minimize the automaton, so I have to draw it again with those states merged. I start with Q0, or let me name it Q03 because I have to merge those two. Now Q0 has an arc to Q1 and Q3 has an arc to Q1 as well. So I keep those Q1 and I don't have to merge Q1 with anything. So I keep those B arc. And I have an A arc from Q0 to Q2. And I have to join Q2 and Q4. So I wrote another state. I name it Q2 and 4 so that you can see that they are the same. And well, I add those trap state again so that you can see that those both is the same or an equivalent automaton. First I keep all those arcs. Now from Q0 or 3 I have an arc. Well, from Q0 I had an arc with an A to Q2 and from 3 to 4, but I merged those two, so those A now goes into those new state. And from Q2 and 4, well, from 2 I had an arc to 3 and from Q4 with one arc would lead me to 3, another would lead me to 2, but those both are now the same, so I write down those new arc with A and B. And now see if those automaton is complete, and it seems complete to me. Now I have to remove the trap state, so I take away this part. And this is my new automaton that accepts the same language as the automaton before, but has a minimal set of states.